We have breaking news. You know it's a day that ends with Y, so it's a breaking news out of this White. There is breaking news out of this White House. The president has tweeted, "I am pleased to announce that I intend to nominate highly respected Admiral Ronnie L. Jackson, MD, as the new Secretary of Veterans Affairs." So he's tweeting that he has a new Veterans Affairs Secretary, which means the current Veterans Affairs Secretary, David Shulkin, who has been under ethics violations or under a cloud of ethics violations, has now resigned. He improperly accepted Wimbledon tickets, among a few other questionable things that are out there. Why does Ronnie L. Jackson sound familiar to you, dear viewer? That's because that is the doctor that the president gets to use. That's the doctor that came to the podium and talked about the president's physical the other day, his mental status. He was also just promoted recently by the president. Peter Alexander is at the White House. Peter, what more can you tell us?
Well, I think the bottom line is the biggest news is that the president is breaking his own news once again by Twitter about this firing. We've been reporting over the course of the last several weeks that David Shulkin's name was at the top of the president's removal list, frankly, in private conversations. I've asked about several of the other cabinet members here about whom there have been questions, and consistently people have focused on David Shulkin as the one that they thought was most likely to depart. You were talking about the inspector general reports privately. I've heard that that's been one of the biggest concerns for this president as it relates to David Shulkin. What's striking about the decision to hire the Rear Admiral Ronnie Jackson to take over that job, again, his personal physician who Americans got to see on that one occasion when he came out before the cameras several months ago and talked about the president's physical health, is it sort of shows you the difficulty this White House, this president, had finding a replacement. We've been told by those close to the president that there were challenges in recent weeks trying to find not only a replacement at the VA, but also an acting secretary there until Ronnie Jackson can be confirmed. I saw him only about a week ago as he was walking around the West Wing with his pressed uniform in hand, and he is now a Rear Admiral, had just been promoted a matter of days ago. He was all smiles, and it makes me wonder whether he had found out that this may be coming from the president on that very day that we were visiting with him.
Peter, remind everybody about what exactly was going on with David Shulkin and why the president had not been happy with him.
Well, there have been a series of inspector general reports that were out there. As you were talking about, one was about some of his foreign travel, specifically when he was traveling with his wife overseas, and the fact that he ended up attending Wimbledon, the tennis tournament when he was there, the handling of some of the costs associated with that. The bottom line is those are the things that in particular that do not sit well with this president. He doesn't like what he views as sort of unforced errors. It's the same reason why the president was frustrated, or at least those around him indicate that he was frustrated about the spending habits of his HUD secretary, Ben Carson, as well, spending $31,000 on a dining room set, or at least saying that he would like to purchase a dining room set for $31,000 before canceling that order. So that was one of the frustrations. And separately, the way I think that David Shulkin had handled himself at the VA. There were concerns here around the West Wing that Shulkin had taken some of his conversations with the president as effectively a green light to get rid of those who he thought were not in support of his efforts at the VA. He was viewed by some as being too combative at the time. You know, from the very start, though, this is a guy the president heavily embraced. He felt strongly that the VA was making real progress. The military, you know how fond the president is of the military and adequately supporting America's troops. And clearly that remains a focus for him as he tries to make a change that benefits all
Peter,
those who serve the military.
The other day he said he's very close to having the cabinet that he wants. Should we expect that anybody else could be going next? I don't know, Ben Carson or somebody potentially?
Good question. I guess the answer is you better watch your phone these days, right? That's how the president makes these announcements. Again, just to be clear, it in my private conversations with those around the West Wing and those close to the president, David Shulkin's name was really the one on the top of this list. We've had conversations about Scott Pruitt at EPA, Ben Carson at HUD, Ryan Zinke, the Interior Secretary. But in all the conversations that I've had, the only name that was really circled was David Shulkin, and it appears for good reason the president making that conclusive decision, announcing it by Twitter, today that he will be gone. It does tell you one more thing about this president. He's as much a media guy as he is a business guy, announcing it to the world, just as he did again today.
You know, and it's interesting timing because everybody has been talking about that New York Times report that said that John Dowd, the president's former lawyer in the Mueller investigation, was asking Paul Manafort and Michael Flynn's lawyers about whether they were interested in a presidential pardon. Certainly a good idea to announce this, I guess, to change the subject. Peter Alexander at the White House. Peter, thank you for rushing to a camera. We appreciate
it. Thanks, Katie.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.